It's cunty, and I love it.
Hey everybody, what's up? It's your girl BB coming at you with another video. And today, we are exploring some music.
I just wanna feel good, like I'm making great time, like I'm doing something right. I just wanna feel alive.
I am no stranger to Selena Gomez. I haven't heard her new single, Love On, and I do believe there is a music video to it, so I was like, let's watch it together. And this video is actually being filmed in preparation for in case Reputation doesn't come out. So if it ends up on YouTube on March 15th, that means I am thoroughly disappointed today that you have to see it on March 15th, because I was hoping my baby Reputation was gonna get released today. Who knows? So I'm making this video just in case, so I still have something to post. And however, if you are seeing this and I did not post it on March 15th, your Reputation TV is out. And you should go watch that video of me reacting to it. Let me scooch over a little bit so we can watch this together. Ooh. Oh, she's so cute.
This doesn't have to be some sort of mathematical equation. Slip off your jeans, slide in the sheets, screaming yes in quotations. Clock in, baby, get to work. Night shift, but with all the perks. Time step and when you fell in love. Time can't mess with you.
The rainbow dress is everything. The titties are tittying. Her in the point shoes is interesting. Oh my god. The yellow dress, stunning. Also, do we talk about the short hair? It's so cute. What are they eating? Pizza rolls? That's funny. This is, yeah. That's so cute. La fin. The end. This song is so like spring fresh. It's so very different from the last couple of albums that she's put out. So I'm really excited to see what her album is like. I don't think it has an official release date, but when it does, girl, just know you're gonna find a video on my channel on that same day. Welcome to my channel. Here we talk about everything dance, Taylor Swift, and all of my fun little lifestyle things. And in between, I hope that you'll subscribe and hit the little bell notification so that way you get notified every single time I post a video. If you subscribe, you'll join the YouTube fam and you'll be a part of a select group that gets to watch me grow into being a professional dancer. You'll be able to say you knew me when.
The song is so sweet. It's very catchy, very unlike what we have heard from her. But it does feel like it right now. It really feels like a lot of musicians are going back to like sort of kind of like the first kind of music that they put out. Like Demi Lovato is back into punk pop. Punk pop. Ariana is finding her way back to that like vintage poppy R&B sound, and Selena is going back to her just very iconic pop. Love You Like a Love Song. That's what this kind of reminds me of. It's just, it's so different but also so true to them, it feels like, and I'm here for it. I love it. I'm not gonna call it rap because I don't think that's what it is, but I'm having a hard time placing it. But the sing talking that she did in the very beginning did throw me off, I'm not gonna lie.
This doesn't have to be some sort of mathematical equation. Slip off your jeans, slide in the sheets.
That threw me through a loop. I wasn't prepared for that. And it was a little awkward, in my opinion. A little choogy, if you will, but it was very cute and very precious, and I ate it up. Like, I fucking loved it. I kind of wasn't expecting it. It came out of nowhere, so it was interesting. It was interesting. But the music video is so pretty. I keep thinking about that rainbow dress that she wears in this, and the yellow dress. And honestly, the black dress when she's on the couch, that outfit is iconic. That is an iconic outfit. This whole music video though is serving. It's cunty and I love it. Cunty pop music for the fucking win, okay? I love this song so much. I am going to be playing this with my windows rolled down, 75 degrees outside, hair blowing in the wind, playing this song. However, let's talk about the point shoes, okay? She never went on point, so it really wasn't that big of an issue, but she was wearing the red point shoes with her cute little white dress. Loved that dress. But when there was a scene or like a little clip of her walking in those shoes, and you could just tell that they were so uncomfortable, her wearing them, and not that she looked awkward, I know what it feels like to walk in point shoes, and I could tell that she just was not comfortable in them. It was a moment. It was a look. It was iconic. And I said this about Taylor. Let's leave the point shoes to ballerinas. My opinion. You can have your own opinion. They're just they're not even my first choice of cute footwear. But it was for the look. To be honest with you, I'm gonna fight back and defend her myself, even though I just said those things. It was for the look. It was for the moment. It was for the iconic moment that she just created on my screen. And so it was worth it, okay? I love this song. I am super excited for the album. Let me look up and see if there's an album release date. This album just feels so fun and so genuine. It really feels like she's having a good time making this music. And truth be told, I really hope there's like just one good ballad on that album, but I hope the rest of this album is gonna be like a summer album. I really want to be able to like end of July, roll my windows down, fly on the interstate, but like go a reasonable amount of speed on the interstate and just listen to this song and get lost driving to the beach, having a good time. I want to be able to play this on the beach when I go. Like, I want more of this sound that we got in Love On. Also, Single Soon is so good. Part of my warm-up series that I do when I teach my dance classes. I'm excited that this is coming soon, and don't take this the wrong way, but I'm also excited that this is her last music project, because I am all for, like, leaving people wanting more. Finishing a part of your career, I don't want to say your whole career, but like finishing out a chapter in your life when it's on a high, it feels like the right thing to do, you know? Obviously, if she wants to make a fourth album, I'm gonna listen to it, I'm gonna buy it, like, I'm gonna have a good time. If she really feels like she doesn't want to do this anymore, put out a banger album and then dip. Babes, that's the best thing you could fucking do, and this album's gonna slap. As for when the next album will be released, Gomez hopes it will come in 2024, but she's not sure yet. She does add that the new music is coming from a place of confidence, reflecting the joy and curiosity she has at the moment. That is from a Rolling Stone article. I love her in her film and television career. I've been with Homegirl since Wiz is a Waverly Place. We've been rocking since, like, 2006, 2007, okay? We've been there together. We've been there and back. Yeah. So, no matter what she does, I'm going to continue to support her and love her. However, there have been some interesting things that have happened on social media recently that I'm like, I don't know if, babes. Anyway. Selena, baby, you're iconic. Love you. You're a little messy boots, but love you just the same, okay? So yeah, I will see you in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below what your favorite part of this music video is or what you hope to see me react to next. Any music videos that you have in mind, any music that I should check out, and react to? I don't know. Let me know, and in that comment, if you could add, let me see what emoji we should use this week. I wish there was a Chick-fil-A emoji. I would just have you put that down there, because I'm really craving some Chick-fil-A today. Let's do the dumpling emoji. This one. Or any sushi emoji if you have it, because I love me some sushi. I will see you in my next video. Peace out, Girl Scout. Bye.